Bill Shorten will find out tomorrow if he'll have competition for the Labor leadership. The Labor power broker has officially put his hand up for the top job and says the party can win the next election.
I want to lead the rebuilding of our movement and to take the fight up to the coalition in Australian politics.
Former Deputy Prime Minister Anthony Albanese will announce his decision tomorrow on if he'll stand. It comes as Kevin Rudd handed over the PM's official residence to Tony Abbott. Meanwhile, embattled Liberal frontbencher Sophie Mirabella has ruled herself out of a cabinet post. She said the decision allowed Tony Abbott to choose his ministry without waiting for the result in her seat, which she could lose. Her opponent in the electorate is cautiously optimistic.
We are just being hopeful about it and imagine that there will be a recount.
Sophie Mirabella was on track to win the seat until 1,000 mystery votes were found by the Electoral Commission. It could be days before a final result is known. After fierce blazes earlier in the week, Sydney residents had another scare today. A fire broke out on the M1 freeway near Lake Macquarie this afternoon. Cars were driving through extreme heat and embers, but amazingly, there were no injuries. Firefighters are also still battling smouldering fires near the Blue Mountains.
We're just blacking out, so we're just securing the edge of the burn so that nothing's going to go into the unburnt area.
So issues like this, is that a concern, spot fires like that?
Yeah, when it's close to the edge, it is, because especially once the weather warms up, if you get a bit of wind, spot overs into the unburnt area are quite dangerous.
That fire will hopefully be fully extinguished in the next few days. Australian researchers have found the use of codeine could make pain worse. Scientists say there's a link between long-term use of the drug and heightened sensitivity to pain. Some users may even start to feel symptoms from things that were painless.
They thought it was just their condition getting worse and therefore I needed to take more painkillers. It wasn't the pain driving the medication, but it was the medication driving the pain.
Codeine is the strongest painkiller available over the counter. South Australia has become the first state to officially crack down on home births. New laws will ban people without qualifications from giving medical assistance. It comes after an inquiry into the deaths of three babies delivered by a deregistered midwife.
There are inherent risks in birth, and a woman should be aware of those. That's why we need someone who has the knowledge and the skills.
Penalties include fines of up to $30,000 or 1 year in jail. Anyone assisting in an emergency situation is exempt. The man jailed for assaulting football great Ron Barassi has had his sentence cut by 2 years. The Court of Appeal has admitted there wasn't enough evidence to prove the severity of the 2009 attack. Travis Bowling had his charge downgraded and his original six-year sentence reduced.
And I thought 6 years, almost not enough for this guy.
Ron Barassi was targeted after going to the aid of a woman being assaulted by Bowling. The 30-year-old will be eligible for parole in February. There's some positive news for the retail sector. David Jones has opened a new suburban store in Melbourne, while Myer has recorded a 200% increase on its online sales. But its annual profits are down 8.7%. Both stores are hoping for a post-election boost.
There's no doubt there have been a large number of imposts on government on expenditure driven by government policy, and that's resulted in the consumers being a little wary.
Myer is building 6 new stores around the country and renovating 3 others. A dashboard camera has captured the moment of a 4-car pile-up in Perth. This video shows a vehicle slamming head-on into a car stopped at traffic lights. Three people were injured in the crash, but not seriously. Police are investigating. 1,000 Rebels bikies have ended their national run across the country. The convoy rode into their Perth clubhouse this afternoon. Police followed the club's every move, conducting license and breath test checks along the way. The run brings together Rebels chapters from across Australia. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 22 degrees in Townsville, 18 degrees in Brisbane, 13 in Sydney, 10 in Melbourne, 12 at the moment in Adelaide and 15 degrees in Perth.